Man, sounds unpredictable fella, man. He can't vote no way. Check again. It's your boy, Ella Boy for President. Checking in with the 19th episode of Set Your Lineup Podcast. To the bottom of me, I have no titty. I got who? I guess he ain't even looking at the screen to know where he at.
Clutch?
No, Clutch go last because he's a little different.
Well, I'll go first. Dude, hey, what's up? This is unpredictable. You know how I always say, I say what they thought I wasn't going to say. I did what I thought they wasn't going to do. I knew what they didn't want me to know. I'm unpredictable.
Next unpredictable, I got who?
The people's champ, the number one seed, the all-time wins leader, all-time money leader in the Hornet's Nest.
Last but not least.
This is your boy Clutch, aka Domino. And you know what it is, baby. Smoke. Podcast.
Welcome to Set Your Lineup, episode 19. 19 weeks straight. No days off, birthdays, 4th of July, all that. We've been here every week. Well, most of us. Most of us have been here every week. Some of us been here every week since they've been added to the show. But it is what we in radio, sports radio land, like to call the dog days of summer. Usually it's like that, but it's a lot of action been going on this summer in sports. Every summer in sports, the WNBA has been here, but has been ignored until now. This is a Olympic summer, so the dog days aren't so dreary this year. So we got a lot going on, but it's football season is on the way. So if you ready for some football, we're gonna get there. Speaking of football, unpredictable. I just want to shout out Nick Sagan Field and. I think it's the second game of the year. They're gonna unveil Nick Saban Field at the Great Bryant Denny Stadium. I think LSU should do the same thing. Name that little weird field with all them numbers in it. Every 5 yards, champ, they got a number going on the field. Just the weirdest. Do they still got them H gold posts? They usually had them H gold posts, the old school one.
Hey,
y'all got the gold post they used to tie brothers up to back in the day. Get some new gold posts and name your fear. Change the name of your fear.
We have dedicated this part of the stadium to Nick Saban. It's on the toilets.
Oh, okay. Y'all
when we flush his ass down a drain.
Y'all donated the state to him in recruiting. We are the boots. Nick Saban,
Has had a great week. He got the stadium named after him, and he couldn't get in the SEC media. That was very fitting for his old ass.
Yeah, shout out to you, Unpredictable. It's a photo floating around on the Blue App on Facebook. And you and Unpredictable were the one that stopped Saban, made him go get his credentials. He should have went and got one of them. Plenty of national championship rings that got made that his credential. But shout out to him. A lot of people said his name should have went on the stadium. I am one of those. You had the president from 1911. You had a president from 1911 on there. He got the bell. It rang every hour at the school. Brian didn't chime. So take them all. Brian Saban. Brian saying, somebody said, Brian Dennis said something to him. We snatched him down, too. I mean, Brian said the wrong word about them. We could snatch him out of stadium, too. Just Nick Saban, Terry Saban, Terry and Nick Stadium. But shout out to them in Tuscaloosa.
Shout out. Nick Saban and Biden must have the same agent.
Why, they quit the same year?
Out of nowhere.
Oh man, good
one. One can't go back to the White House, the other one can't get in the SEC media. Mm. Top flight security. I don't know who you are, but I salute you. You did a great job.
And they knew who he was, too.
That's a power move.
Yeah.
Different job, you gotta do different things. So let's go ahead and start the show. I don't think this is gonna be a long show, because I don't know what he is, the COO or what, of this podcast. He's not here, but he didn't say he didn't want to be too long, too many topics. No, did he? But shout out to DSPN. I think DSPN is reporting presidential topics or something today, because that he wanted to be the first one to send that out, that we are in search for a new Democratic nominee. If you can see right there, vote me in. Me or LeBron? I wouldn't be able to beat LeBron.
You're right. Yeah,
just like you can't beat JJ Reddick. All right.
JJ Reddick. Y'all hope he listen to this. I think he hot garbage.
All right, let's talk Caleb Williams' contract incentive. Does anybody know what his incentive was and what he turned out? People Champ, I'm going to have to run with you because you and DSPN really be on that type of time.
Yeah, he had a four-year, $39 million deal, $25.5 million signing bonus with a fifth-year option. He decided not to have an agent, but he did have his lawyers. He had a crew of lawyers to go with him. A couple of things that he wanted that the NFL declined on. He wanted to be paid as an LLC, and he wanted the team not to franchise him, to give him the franchise tag. So the NFL declined on both of those options. And he eventually signed, and he's a Chicago Bear, ready to start training camp next week.
Appreciate it. PSPN checking in. Sometimes you can get one man to replace two people.
Same thing I said about Larry.
Hey, but I think it was a smart thing to do is to ask to be paid as an LLC because you know, LLC, you pay that money to the LLC. What are you going to do? Take all that money, put over in his, put over in another account in case, you know, he have some off the field issues and they want to, you know, sue him or get money. They want to sue the LLC. And the only thing they'll be able to get is what's in that LLC. So that was a smart move. I knew it wasn't going to work, but that was a smart move.
I agree.
Did somebody get paid in Bitcoin before?
With Odell?
Yeah,
Odell.
Pam, how they want to be paid?
And he lost out.
You know what, though? I like the move by the young man, just kind of thinking outside the box. When I started looking at the agents and things like that, I never really understood why you need one. You know, just go get some lawyers, pay them their little small fee or whatever. One time, instead of paying 3-4% every year on your contract. So I like the move that he's making when you're trying to be a independent business owner or proprietor, trying to take control of that narrative, especially when you're trying to do it as the number one pick who everybody wanted, not the 55th pick when only your dad and your mama wanted you. when you play that great and your services is in that much of a demand, maximize your potential. That's just me. Now, when you're lucky to be there, sometimes shut up and dribble. And you can't really do that because we've seen the turnovers.
Well, unpredictable. Don't get it twisted. I did want you as your father, but I just had I was young. I had some stuff to handle. But is that on this topic?
I got it. Can I ask Champ? Why did the NFL state why they didn't approve of it? Or did they just shut it down completely? Like, what was the reasoning?
They didn't give a reason.
They didn't?
Nope. Yeah, no comment. So,
now, to me, well, I think they should give a reasoning as to why. Because maybe it's not good for their brand. You know, like, I don't know. I would want to know the reason why.
Well, now, his receiver did sign right behind him, Odunze. So,
yeah.
That's a positive.
Okay. Now, as far as the franchise tag, I would have gave him that.
Yeah.
I would have gave him that. If you don't want to be franchise, let him go on and move on.
Yeah. That's why I say I was wondering, what did they give a reason? You know, to me, did they give a reason, number one? And number two, why did they feel the need to step in as the shield, not the Chicago Bears individually? Like,
well, I think the reason is probably because that if you start having one person do a whole lot of unnecessary stuff, then next year you'll have 10 people trying the same scenario that he just tried. So if they go ahead and nip it in the bud now, then they ain't got to work too much worry about that type of stuff coming up in the future. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Shout out to the NFL then. Maybe the NBA should took note of that at number 55.
Yeah, NBA is ran by the players for real.
Yeah.
EA Sports did the same thing when they let Archie Boy. They let him get a $60,000 and finesse them that way. So the NFL typically did like my mama used to say, because I said so.
Basically, yeah.
Like
Bronco Nation did with his league. When he asked to vote on, do we want 50 or 100? Did he? He just went up to 100.
Trump got these folks like that, man. Ain't no democracy. So we're speaking on contracts. I mean, the Caleb Williams contract has been signed. I don't know who made a mistake in that, them or not. But the boy wanted a no trade clause, so he might know. He might know some.
Caleb Williams?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Cause the Bears will trade you and you end up being a punt returner. You be a quarterback and you end up leaving being a punt returner. So let's speak on some more contracts since that was semi important. I know another name, but you guys are going to get to learn unpredictable. And it's a couple of names that drive unpredictable. LeBron James, now Brandon James, Nick Saban, and Tua Tagovailoa. Tua Tagovailoa has not been issued, has not been re-signed, has not received an extension. And he's on his final year of his rookie deal. Well, he played his final year of his rookie deal, and now he's on his fifth-year option, which guarantees him $23.1 million for the 2024 season. Some people have done this. Baker Mayfield, Sam Darnold, Lamar Jackson are the last three to play on their fifth-year option. Are the Dolphins messing up by not giving Tua an extension now?
Yeah, because he's going to come out this year. And the whole thing is he was injured for his first 2 to 3 years. So last year was basically his first year where he was fully healthy and everything lined up for him. So he had a great year, led the league in passing. So this year he's going to come out and he's going to have another one of my outstanding years. And where they could have probably got him at 40 million, 45 million, now they're going to have to play 50, 55 million for him.
Facts. And they gave him another weapon. OBJ. They gave him another weapon to get the job done. And
he'll play four games this year.
Don't do that. Cause that's why I was trying to pick him up last year. Cause when they in that contract, when they in that contract year, they usually come out strong. But if Tua chooses not to re-sign or isn't offered the right amount, what team could y'all see him on?
Pittsburgh.
That's bad, man. That's bad.
I don't know.
Pittsburgh.
Maybe the Raiders.
No, I'm thinking a team that you're familiar with, my good sir.
Who, me?
Yeah, you. Very familiar with.
I know you're talking about the Cowboy.
You know it. But, you know man, it. They could trade him out now. Dak going to Miami anyway. They could trade him out now. That's an even swap to me.
Nah, they ain't no even swap.
Nah, it ain't.
They ain't no even swap.
Tua ain't had no boot on. That's an even swap.
Here's a question for Tua. I'm gonna be non-biased. I'm gonna go just keep it. Forget about what's good. I'm gonna act like he went to LSU. Does Tua really deserve a high contract?
Yeah.
This is why I asked that, because we talked about his stats. But you went out there and got one of the most dangerous receivers in the draft that played with Bama, Waddle. Then you went and got the most dangerous receiver, maybe one of, if not the top five most dangerous receiver ever to play football in Hill.
Both of them got paid. Go ahead.
Then you go out there and you go get these top-notch linemen. So it's like the way I understand the salary cap is this. The more money we give you, the less we give everybody else. But from what I've seen is this. Tua is a good quarterback. I'm not going to throw no shade on him. But is he one of those quarterbacks I would throw this boatload of money for me to start losing talent? I would say no.
Would you pay?
He hasn't shown what he could do without that talent.
Would you pay him more than Sunshine in Jacksonville?
Yeah, I would.
Would you draft him?
I don't know about that one.
Would you draft him? We know you come from a place that don't know how to handle quarterbacks anyway. Clutch, aka Domino.
I would say no, only because of this. I look at what's around Sunshine, the offensive weapons, and what's around Tua. And I would say that Tua has some dangerous weapons. I think Sunshine has some good weapons. They're you can win. You can win a Super Bowl with those weapons being good, but there's nobody elite where Sunshine can say, you know what? Let me throw as far as I can and let him run for it. He got two of them. Then you got Jonah Smith, who had a pretty good year at Tennessee before he went to the Patriots. Nobody does good with them no more. But now you got him, who was pretty much on a Pro Bowl level at tight end. You got A-Chain at running back. And then the one you had Mostert, who probably, for the most part, the best running back in football, if you take off the names of the jerseys, for the most part last year. So you put all this speed around this person. So when you're putting all of this around him, and now you're saying be the highest paid, something has to go. And if he was supposed to be on that level, why would you have to go get so many parts to make him look good?
And I'm going to be unbiased. Today going to be an unbiased day.
Yeah.
I'm going to say you proved a great point. And to me, Tua, I can't tell another man how to count his money, but Tua should play the route like Jalen Brunson. Let him build around you and make you look good.
Because Tua is a timing quarterback. Everything has to be, you know, he has to take them and he has to let that ball go. And when he take that third step, that ball got to be out of his hand. If his timing is messed up, he doesn't have the talent or the ability to, in my opinion, to scramble and get out of the pocket and make a play. Because anytime he gets out of the pocket and he throws that ball, he throws a lot of picks when he does it, because he makes bad decisions. He throws back across the field and things of that sort. So, I mean, that's why I wouldn't draft him over Sunshine.
Yeah.
In fantasy football, I do need to get that last spot in Hornets, son, because you got him saying he would draft Sunshine over Tua.
I would. Also, I look at it from this standpoint. I don't think that Sunshine is that much better than Tua. But when I look at some of the quarterbacks under this new regime over the last 15 years, I wasn't a Tom Brady fan. I said he's not that good. But when I seen them take away all his weapons, and I started saying, damn, who the hell is his receivers he been winning with? When you got to go back and scratch your head, like, we saw Montana the Rice. We saw Young the Rice, Michael Irvin and Aikman. We saw Peyton Manning, Marvin Harrison, and Reggie Wayne. And that's not to say individually that these quarterbacks were not good. But when I started seeing Tom Brady winning with receivers, like, who the hell are they? Then I saw Drew Brees as far as his stats. I'm saying his stats. But he was always an elite quarterback, and every year they were changing out his receivers without a true number one receiver that we can say. So, and this is where I think Dak is top 10 quarterback, but this is where we don't give him enough credit. He's had different number one receivers almost every year, different coordinators, different running backs. We put the pressure on Dak. I don't think Dak by himself can win the Super Bowl, but if you can keep that number one and two receiver consistent and give him a half decent running game, for example, you take the weapons that Tua got, put them weapons in Dallas. We'll be saying right now, Dak Prescott probably he up there with Patrick Mahomes because year in and year out, they would be able to win. But when you watch the game, when they double team 88, and I seen them other receivers for Cowboys couldn't get open one-on-one, it fell on Dak, but he's the quarterback, but they didn't do a lot to get open. So Tua is good, and I think he's one of the top – I put Tua in the top 12 quarterbacks. I'm not going to disrespect him as it's what he can do, but a lot of his stats, has he gotten better? It came with them additions that they have. So who do you lose at that point? I guess that'd be my question. If he gets more money, who's coming off the board?
Yeah, but when you're trying to build a team, though, you want to be with the best players you got that's around you. So if you put more money into your defense, then that's less money you got to put into your offense. Or if you put more money into your offense, that's less money you got to put in your defense. So Wherever you put your money at, some other part of your team going to be lacking. So Miami may just be putting their money into their offensive player spots, whereas Dallas putting theirs in their offensive line. They got a high-end defensive player. So it's all about where you put your money into. So it's just saying that he just got good weapons. That's what they putting their money into. So they feel like they can win with having better weapons and more so than having a better defense compared to maybe some of the other teams, like Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh put all their money to their defense, so they don't put nothing to their offense. So that's why they're in the middle of the road every year. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah. But when you do put your money in a quarterback, people talk about you. If you do draft a quarterback and you put money in a free agent quarterback, you draft a quarterback top 10, people talk about you bad. So shout out, rise up.
How about this? Today, and I'm just saying, like, I think he deserves money. How much, if I'm sitting here saying, if I'm a Miami Dolphins fan, I want him to get his money, but I don't want him to have to compromise the pieces that's around the team to help us be successful. So I would say this. I think Tua has started with 3 years. You know, off and on, I know he had some years that he didn't finish, but he's been basically a three-year starter. Can we say respectfully that we've seen more from Jordan Love this year and also that rookie from Houston this year to think that they don't have the weapons that he have. But I think we have more respect for those two in their first year, and we still kind of questioning Tua. So if we still kind of questioning him, and the difference between Tua and Sunshine also is Sunshine putting seats in the stadium. Tua, they're not coming to see Tua. They're coming to see Hill. They're coming to see that explosion. Is he worth it at that point?
Yeah, but I think with Miami,
most of carried my fantasy. I'm sorry, Champ. Most of carried my fantasy football team last year. Go ahead.
I think with Tua, I think it's more so he had a good year last year. He played the whole year, so they want to see if he can do it again. If he can go out there and play another whole year without having no concussion problems or getting hit and banged up or whatever, then I think they're gonna pay him. So. I think that's that. If I was in the GM office, that's what I would be doing. If he could stay up another year, I would give him the money. You know,
to compromise your team.
Well, I mean, you're paying them quarterbacks anyway. It's a new era with them quarterbacks. The GPA is up. It's up to $50 million. So you're gonna have to just pay him.
Everybody gets just 50. Pay Dak.
Everybody gets 50.
I think Dak deserves to be paid, but the flaw that Dak made to me, and get your money. Let's talk. Let's say I don't want to take away nobody money, but I'm speaking as a fan for my team. The mistake Dak made was this. I just say putting pieces around Dak. If Dak didn't take the money that he took, let's say he could have took a little less, he would still have Amari Cooper. So now you have a two-man receiving crew that's pretty much dangerous that now they can't double team. And when he had both of those players, from a team success, playoff success, and also individual success, that was his best year because you couldn't double team. But now when you lose a number one target like Cooper because you took a little bit too much money, you got to bring in these journeymen that's not even – and I take that back. I can't think of the little white receiver. He played in a slot. He was a reliable catcher.
Beasley.
So you lost two weapons. One, Beasley was a red zone weapon and a first down mover. You lost two weapons because he probably got $10 million more a year than probably what he should have for the sake of the team. So – when I'm giving money like that, I've watched Mahomes lose weapons and still be considered the very best and still win championships. I watched Lamar Jackson. I feel bad for him because he don't have nothing and still win. I watched the guy for the Chargers. His players are always hurt, and they still find ways to win. So, yes, you give them the money. I don't know if I give Tua the money because if you give Tua the money, you're going to start losing some people. And can he keep the franchise afloat? Because you're giving him money and not dispersing it.
But then they paid Zeke before they paid Dak and the receiver.
I think that's
where they messed up at.
Didn't Dak go to Cabo? I mean, not Dak. Didn't Zeke go to Cabo when he was up? Because I think he got paid last.
They might play Zeke first, I want to say.
They're like $95 million or something.
Yeah,
come in with the facts. Shout out to Tree Man. Joe.
See, that's why they blew their wad at right there. No, did it, but they but that you paying that running back all that money and he down here. You done already used him up for 6 years in a row. You know, and instead of paying you. Yeah, but you could see him falling off the cliff though. You know, I ain't saying he shouldn't have got his money, but you have to know when to leave a player alone, get out. It's like saying fantasy, you got to know when to, in dynasty, you got to know when to get off a player and pick up another one, trade him off. Right. And
do y'all think they could go the route that the 49ers are doing? Because Twitter going crazy because Mahomes, I think, threw a 90-yard pass to Xavier Worthy. And,
you
don't
know 90-yard pass, man. Stop.
Oh, yeah. Well, it done made news.
I use this analogy.
I ain't been interrupted in 27 minutes and 23 seconds.
When I look at the quarterback, I think the quarterbacks deserve their money because they are the people you coming to see. Now, KC, we going to see Mahomes. I was even talking about Drew Brees. We went to go see Drew Brees. You go see Aaron Rodgers. You go to see Peyton Manning. Is anybody really going to see Tua? Because I think Tua and Sunshine, I think Sunshine still has more potential. But those fans are coming to see Sunshine, no matter what we say. But even though I got Bronny James behind me, I understand the business side of why the Lakers got Bronny James to put seats in their summer league. Sell jerseys, but I just think the Lakers franchise is too great to fall for that dog and pony show. But Jacksonville, they're putting seats in Jacksonville because of Sunshine. I don't think they're really coming to see Tua. I think they're coming to see what Waddle and Hill go do next.
What if Tua come back this year and done what he did last year or exceeded what he did last year? Because I believe they're afraid to dump this money and invest in him because of on that Thursday night against Cincinnati, he got froze with the game. He was throwing up the game sign. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's wrong. That's wrong. I should have, my bad, Tua. But
my boy.
Tua is very, very accurate, but he's a small quarterback. So if they do invest in him, they need to beef up the line of scrimmage and protect their investments, because their skill position is insane. You know, A-Chain and the other dude they drafted in the fourth round. So they got speed to kill. They the greatest speed on turf. But I think they're just leery of giving all this money to the Tua, and they see what happened on that Thursday night again, and they be like, man, why we give up all this money? Because if you don't have a quarterback, you cannot win in the league. You're not successful in this league. Mm-hmm. Back in the day, you can get away with Brad Johnson, Trent Dilfer. I'm trying to think of somebody else.
Brock Purdy.
Who's Matt that?
Brock Purdy.
Brock Purdy's pretty good, though.
I think I'll take Purdy over Tua.
Man, you just got some hate against out. Not some hate, a lot of hate against
out. No, this is an unbiased show today.
No, but guess what, Joe?
Look at the tape on Tua, man. Tua makes some great anticipation throws. And kudos to him for coming back. I didn't think he was going to survive after what he went through, because I ain't have him on none of my fantasy team, because I was terrified to death that, you know, because once you get a concussion, you're susceptible for getting more concussions. And I want to go through that misery, pain and misery, you know, but I think he's going to put on a show this year. I think it's going to be more deadlier.
They said if you don't like concussions, don't talk crazy and hornetness this year.
Easy, welcome back, baby.
I heard they got my boy Easy E back.
Yeah, he back.
Happy belated birthday to Easy E.
In terms of talent,
ain't nobody come on the thing after you made your post. I said, I ain't gonna be the first guy after you saying it. I said, somebody come on and said, and I'll come on, but ain't nobody come. I'm like, wow, this is some cold blooded killers up in this league, ain't
it? Yeah. What's the update before we close the subject? We did go into talking to it and Dak in their final years of their contract. Because the Caleb Williams contract that ESPN, that kind of went real quick, prom night. But go ahead.
I think when I look at Patrick Mahomes, I think he's the perfect example of who should get paid. He's the standard, and also Lamar Jackson. And this is why I say that. If Patrick Mahomes could have kept his original offensive squad intact, we forget he had that running back before he got in trouble, who was probably Kareem Hunt, was one of the best running backs in the league, still relatively young. He lost him, still got MVP. He lost Tyreek Hill, Super Bowl MVP, regular season MVP. He lost he found a running back because we didn't know who running back was going to be. We didn't know his other receivers. He still found ways to still get to the Super Bowl and win. So when you get paid, you have to understand you're going to lose weapons. And can Tua be effective without Waddle? What if he lose Waddle and Mostert? Can he still be as effective? So when you get paid, you got to realize that the more you get paid, the more it's going to be on you, and now it's scrutiny. That's why I say the scrutiny on Dak is fair, because he took a little bit too much money to keep Amari Cooper. But it's not fair based on his production. But some of the mistakes that he made, I think if he had Cooper and took a little bit less money, it'd have made his life a little bit easier.
And to go on to what you were just saying, the Texans just signed Cam Akers. So they're trying to load up around that young man, especially on the rookie contract.
I like Cam. Trying to load up with Cam Akers. That's a load up. Oh.
I'm just saying. Brunson, he gave you the
that man wasn't even in the league last year.
The blueprint.
He was on your fantasy team, wasn't you?
He was in the league.
Where he played at?
The Rams.
He got traded to the Vikings.
He probably snatched him up. He ain't that Joe in fantasy football.
I don't know that man touching the field.
You ain't no but a dumpster diver. You a dumpster diver in fantasy football. So as soon as he,
I don't even know what dumpster diver means.
That dig in the trash can. They go behind the grocery store, dig in the trash can.
So you calling me a coon? A black man called another man coon?
Never that, man. Why you got all them Falcons hats? That's kind of starting to bother me.
I'm in love with a stripper. I said you can find the strippers in Atlanta, so. Atlanta, here I call. That's the way. Cool, baby. We did it, Jimmy.
Yeah, he on that. Yeah, I forgot he said he was on that. All right, man. That was a great discussion. I'm glad I had that in the tuck because ESPN was telling me to get rid of all these topics we had to go with Caleb Williams. But another quick question I got.
Vikings had Madison, Alexander Madison, and the fast dude. They ain't had no Cam Akers.
Yeah, they did.
Well, he didn't play.
He played. He got hurt.
Got hurt, yeah.
What was his injury?
His knee.
Oh.
Same thing going to happen to him this year.
He cooked.
Well, listen, I got a quick question. I appreciate it, John, because my mom done called my phone 3 times.
Uh-oh.
I got a quick she brought me a snack, some waters or something she did, something nice. She a nice
good.
She trying to stay out the Shady Grove because she punished me 1 year in 2000 and I told her she gonna have to do 6 months in the Shady Grove assisted living.
Why you got your hair permanent wax and you ain't got no hat? You been smoking trees or something? What's going on?
Nah, they're my locks. They just want to lock up. The Cuba.
Different lighter box yourself.
No, yeah, cause I can't get my webcam to go. I got a new iPhone and I was trying to hook it up, waiting on you, but can't had to go. Right. All y'all look. 1080p, and I'm bad off, but I'm gonna fix it. But look, Joe Burrow says if the NFL goes 18 weeks, it should be 2 bye weeks, and one should be a bye week for everybody, and put the Pro Bowl in that slot in that bye week, around week 13 maybe. Agree or disagree? Yes or no? Clutch, yes or no?
No.
Champ?
No.
Trigger Man?
That'd be a strong no as well.
Unpredictable?
Yes.
And I agree with unpredictable. Lord have mercy.
And why is that? Give me your take.
Because he's my son. That's why. Champ, tell me why. Champ. No, Trigger Man, you had a strong no. You know, you fill out the little paperwork, likely, unlikely, very. You had a strong no. Why?
Okay, so how many weeks in the league right now?
17.
And you add one more week. You want one more bye week for adding a week?
Add one more game.
They have shortened the preseason, correct?
Yeah.
Right. But,
Don't change your answer, champ.
I ain't gonna change it. Okay, what I'm saying is,
we tend to agree on stuff,
the last couple of years. Maybe he wants that if he can have a strong postseason run or whatever, but I don't see it. I don't see it gaining no traction or anything like that. But
what's not gonna happen is they're not finna put no Pro Bowl in there for that week for you to get hurt. You know, they're not finna do that.
They playing flag.
They're still, old boy tore his knee up and lost his career about 15 years ago playing in the sand out there. So they're not finna do that. The owners ain't gonna sign off on that.
The running game now, back from the Patriots.
Yeah. As far as the 2 weeks, now you can give them the 2 weeks, but they ain't finna give you everybody be off 1 week, that same week. You know what I'm saying? You can space it out. You know, you get the fifth and you get the 10th. Like that, but you ain't finna get everybody just to be off on that 1 week. They're not finna do that. That's too much money lost.
Oh, yeah. Not gonna happen.
You know what I'm saying?
You gonna make the money up with the Pro Bowl.
The owners ain't going for that Pro Bowl stuff. I'm telling you that now.
I mean,
if they did that, the Pro Bowl would be full of a whole bunch of alternates.
The Pro Bowl used to be a game that everybody looked forward to, the fans looked forward to seeing, but now there's people don't care about the Pro Bowl. The players don't care. We don't care. Puff Daddy don't care. You know, R. Kelly don't. Nobody cares. You can't find nobody. You know what I'm saying?
That's why the great white T. Hope is trying to fix it. But the Pro Bowl, Pro Bowl, I mean, whatever name, Broto, whatever, what I said that man's name was? Well, Joe Burrow. Burrow trying to fix it. You put the Pro Bowl like you do the WNBA, like you do the NBA All-Star Game, like you do the MLB All-Star Game. I mean, they're with football. I mean, come on.
Now, if it was Patrick Mahomes, if Patrick Mahomes would have said that, it would be strong considerations and traction on it.
Well, I thought Pro
Throw had. But when he talk, people listen.
Man, shout out to Pro Throw. He talking about me, man. I met Pro Throw before.
You got heard of Alabama?
Yeah.
Yeah, I met him before. We was in Matt. No, ooh, let me not say where I met him at. We was in a facility.
Cause that McDonald's buffet, what?
No.
McDonald's bathroom.
Buffet. No,
it was a buffet in there, but it wasn't no McDonald's. It wasn't no McDonald's. It was money falling from. All right. So unpredictable. You agree with it, like I did. What's up?
I think when you start extending the season, they do need a break in between because football is a physical sport. So I think it'll give everybody a chance to heal, regenerate, reboot. The Pro Bowl is just it's non-existent anyway, so it's not like it'll be missing something. You do it before the Super Bowl. So, you know, and I look at the other sports, they all do their Pro Bowl in the middle of the season. But it'll give those people there you go. It'll give them a chance to just reboot, come back, see some of our better players come back healthier so that their body hasn't been able to kind of start over a little bit. So I think it's more about the physical contact that they're constantly getting every time.
So this is the same person that be dogging NBA. Hey, that boy flexed up today, man. Yeah, he flexed up. I don't like y'all wearing all the llama stuff, though. But,
they said it was on sale at Walmart this week.
Not the Mike Vick. The Mike Vick don't never go on sale, huh? That's an icon. Listen, unpredictable.
Yeah.
You the same man to be chewing out basketball players for taking off, right?
But I don't chew them all. I never say nothing when LeBron asks for an extension for the All-Star break to make it a week. I just say they're sensitive when they hurt their little pinky, and I didn't pay my money to go watch them play, and they on the bench.
Right. But then the NBA turned around and did that, but then they turned around and added the irrelevant championship in the middle of the season that the Lakers and LeBron won. So they're going to get you. They're going to get you one way or the other. Just like them folks I work for. They're going to get you coming up, going. They're going to get you. But
it's crazy how all the sports, the All-Star game, the NBA All-Star game, Pro Bowl, all of it is just it has no meaning anymore. It's got no life to it. You used to look forward to it, you know? But now everybody done started getting paid. Then they got Hollywood, and it's just disappointing. I'm surprised the fans show up at all for these venues and stuff. I guess they want to listen to the rapper, whoever they have for the occasion, to hype the crowd up and this and that, but it's crazy.
Oh, you ain't never been to All-Star Weekend. You don't know.
They messed up when they took the Pro Bowl from Hawaii. When they took it from Hawaii, they messed it up.
Nobody want to go to Hawaii, man. All the Hawaii player come over here. They ought to have a Pro Bowl in Vegas every year around the 13th week and have it just like they've been doing. They can even throw a basketball game in and have them playing basketball against each other. A week full of activities
Vegas always a good draw.
Yeah, you playing in the air.
They've been trying to get like an NBA team out there in Vegas.
Yeah, they're waiting on a Brown retire.
It's coming.
Hey. I was talking to my other son about this yesterday about how we play for the love, we play for the hunger, but we also play with pride. Like, whenever we went out there, we wanted to perform at our best, no matter what. And if Joe was if I lived in Huntsville and I had the fastest 100 meters, and Joe was in Montgomery, he had the fastest 100 meter time. My goal when I saw Joe on that track was not to beat you, but humiliate you to realize that you're not even on my level.
I appreciate that.
It was a spirit. It wasn't just competition. I wanted to dominate in every possible way. I think they just too friendly. They want to win. But they want to make it. They want everybody to win. And in actuality, they all won back then. But now it's more like, I got mine, you get yours. No, did it. Right?
And then a lot of these, the NBA circuit now is, these guys are AAU buddies, and they done played ball all together throughout, you know, their childhood and all that stuff. So back then, you had those true rivalries, even though they might be friends in the offseason. But these cats would do whatever it takes to hoist the trophy at the end of the season. Like when me and Xavier was in the Marine Corps, and we played.
The Marines shut us out. They shut you out because you finna tell too much business. Try it again. You still off, cuz.
Hey, I just don't think they play for pride no more.
We can't hear you. And it's not showing mute.
Yeah. See it. See it.
You, watch. Yeah. You said Marine.
He on his own. I did not endorse nothing that he's
okay.
Man touching me. Wow. That phone call really messed me up and had my head.
Oh, yeah, that the Marine calling you saying you don't say too much, Holmes.
Hey, trying to get back in. Joe Biden and left, they need help.
Go ahead. Go ahead, what you were saying.
And you got to start over because we didn't hear you.
Oh, you did?
Not all the way from 1932. But
wow, that's crazy, man.
Just start over after you said that the Marine call.
I said, well, me and X, we played football in the Marine Corps and several other Marine Corps brothers. And it would be a total disrespect if I am, because most of them be on the opposing team going against each other. But when I'm breaking off a long run or whatever, and he got me in sight, I expect him to bring the pain, bring the hurt, bring the wood. So, no did it. And vice versa, you know, it's the way we play the game. We play it hard, we play it fast, we play it pissed off, and we still gonna be boys at the end of the day, but we lose respect for each other if you don't play the game the way the game's supposed to be played. Don't cheat the game. I believe if you cheat the game, you wind up some type of way getting hurt.
I be forgetting y'all was in the Marine Corps. I'm going to stop talking to y'all. I've been talking to y'all lately.
I was talking to Lil Edward about that, and we were talking about one-on-one. And one time we was playing, I missed the shot, and I got the rebound. He said, my ball. And I was like, huh? And he says, we was talking about it. He said, yeah, you missed four times, but you made one. You was 1-for-5. I said, we playing one-on-one, not stats. So it's almost like you go take away me out hustling you, trying to work for a shot, and you go make me shoot, and then if I miss, I can't get the ball. And I say, that's not one-on-one. That's almost like, hey, that's like when you're warming up, you make it, they throw it back. But it's no competition.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so, you know, that's why with these sports, it's almost like you play for you want to get paid. At the end of the day, the money's the money. But they don't have that obstacle of saying, not only did I race Joe, but I destroyed him the way Usain Bolt destroyed everybody in the Olympics, where he jogging and still running 9.5. And I beat you and I humiliated you to realize that you shouldn't even be on a track with me, or you shouldn't be on the court with me. Now they're just so friendly. Everybody wants to dap off. It's just the spirit of competition is gone.
Right, right. No wonder you love Brandon James. You putting up his numbers out there on the court with a little Elwood, man. But
I ain't go 1-for-5. You know what I did? I was 50% because I missed on purpose so I can get the easy layup for the rebound.
Oh, okay. But look, DSPN, do you mind me asking another question? That one. Okay, he don't mind.
Yeah.
All right. All right. Should the NFL leave Christmas games alone? Leave it to the NBA or not? Anybody?
No. Put as many NFL games on as possible.
No.
Everybody home from work. Everybody watching.
It used to be a time of it wasn't Christmas games. You had the Thanksgiving game. Now you're taking families away on two major, major holidays, but I guess the union and the players had fought against it, and the NFL is going to keep pushing the envelope, and they're going to back up. They are entertaining going into more countries to bring football to the world and stuff. So international.
Brazil.
Yeah, all right, they love black people.
Keeping in between the mayonnaise and the mustard, man, right in here. Just Christmas. No, yeah.
What's mayonnaise and mustard? What they got to do?
That's the white lines in the middle of the road and the yellow line on the side.
Boy, so you somebody good, say, boy.
No, boy, dude good, told me boy. That first day he Big Ruben told me that first day he was training me. Yo, first day.
Right. I'm 53 years old. I ain't never heard that little line.
No, Diddy.
He wasn't training me, but the first day he was right when I had my driver's license, I didn't have it all the way yet. He said, hey, big daddy, keep between the mustard and the mayonnaise. And I just, huh? And I looked at the road. I said, he talking about he between them. But
boy.
But so I mean, Clutch, you said yes or no?
No.
No. Don't.
How can y'all say no in good conscience when we played fantasy? Even when fantasy wasn't around, we loved football. And after all days of spending Eve with the family, opening gifts, and to click that TV on and sit down and enjoy some NFL football. I don't know about you guys, but I enjoy NFL, even before fantasy, way more than college football. I'm just an NFL guy.
Right.
But
and you
try to say college is more or whatever. No. NFL is
where I mean, in the stadium and there, but you gonna tap into this college when it's time to pod now. But mean, that's what I'm saying, Joe, we barely can get you on a Saturday, Joe. So Christmas.
What are you saying? When you try to get me on Saturday? Yesterday?
Last night.
I can't help when stuff pop up. Like I can't.
Two weeks before you had a barbecue. You had to go to the movies with your family. Come on, girl.
Yeah, I mean, Christmas is family. I'm a wanted man. I mean,
that's what I'm saying. So we don't need Christmas.
That's why I'm paying my dues now because they already know September when that thing. Well, no, when we had a fantasy party at my house, they already know they're gonna lose their father, their husband, their friend, their confidant for a designated period of time. Pray for me.
Okay, pay your dues.
I ain't always been saved. Pray for me.
I like that, but man, that man fantasy nastiness on Christmas. No, man. Leave it to the NBA where you can kind of glance at the games or sit down or sit aside. I don't want let man. We got Thanksgiving. Let the NFL take over Thanksgiving.
Man, you ain't getting up but a pair of socks and a tie for you for Christmas. No way.
Yeah.
So after you get through unwrapping them socks, it's time to watch the football.
You done kicked out by the grand.
Yeah.
That's the problem. I've been on work on three jobs for Christmas. I need to rest on Christmas.
When Christmas comes, or even without Christmas, people spend money they don't have on things they don't need to impress people they don't even like. And they still in debt from last Christmas, and then you're gonna go into more debt this Christmas. We have a problem. We are the biggest consumers, and we just don't. We're killing us. You're killing yourself, Petey.
Well, brother Muhammad Akbar, we appreciate your take on Christmas.
But you know what, Joe? I would say this. At first, I was against it, thinking about the players. But then again, when you play for certain teams and certain brands like the Cowboys, the Redskins, those traditional Lions. Steelers, when you asking for that money, you also got to realize they play on holidays also.
So absolutely. It comes with it.
Also, there's always this big thing great about point. Who's more popular, the NFL or the NBA. Love here that. It is. It's Christmas. Everybody's home. They get to pick what they watch. Let the people speak for what they want at that point.
Man, we already know that absolutely. That argument. That ain't even an argument. That ain't even Bron and Jordan. That's like Jordan and Pippen. I don't know. Like
you
know,
I work with this company called Alec here. I've worked on every holiday on the calendar because when you on call, when someone need oxygen or bed or whatever, they don't care nothing about what day it is. They need what they need. So you got to. That's your job. You go where your job's sending you.
Hey, can you put me on? I be. Off on the other jobs on all holidays. I can work. That can be my fourth.
I talk to a supervisor named Easy. I put you on.
Oh, never mind.
Come on, man.
I wouldn't get the schedule until 10 minutes before it come out.
It might be, for the Ravens, it might be interesting to see them just to say put the Lakers with LeBron against Kevin Durant or maybe the Warriors at a primetime game when you got a 12-2 Buffalo, I mean Baltimore with Lamar Jackson in it for the MVP against Patrick Mahomes and, you know, Kansas at 13-1. They playing for home field advantage. Mike, get the people what want.
Come on, man.
See what they go with.
You just ruined my perfect segue. I was talking about jobs, and I was going to say, speaking of jobs, so let me – yeah, Joe, I don't need the job no more.
Hey, y'all get the word out. Easy, if y'all there, you're listening. Hey, I expect to see you at my fantasy party, man.
If he ain't coming, if Freddie eat for both of them.
I know that. No doubt about that.
Never mind. I do need the job. I gotta get my horn in this. If he's in.
But that's straight up, though. I expect to see him, though. He need to let bygones be bygones and come on back into the fold, because
You can see me at
left and right, you know.
You can see me at the spot in Bravo, or you can see me at the Wild Wing. I don't know about it. The first time me seeing you pulling up at Joe House. I don't know.
Come on, man. That's the safest place on earth. But the thing is, he don't come out to. We've been doing this thing about 6 years. You know how many times he's been out to the fellowship?
Once.
And when Sim's owed him $5, we was at Bomb House.
Well, y'all be trying to sit at the table with them big stools, them big tall stools.
Man, come on, man.
What out there, my dude? He don't respond to me or nothing on Facebook. But I don't know. Anyway, speaking of jobs and speaking of
family, come see about family.
Speaking of little men and jobs, Skip Bayless leaving Fox Sports. PSP. Oh, I got you, Jeff. Y'all done dog Skip Bayless so much. Shout out to his illustrious career after Uncle Shay Shay. Skip Bayless.
Put your glasses back on. You're not going to do anything.
PSPN, what you got? What you thinking, man?
Well, my observation of this is sometimes you can get on that high horse and you think you're the number one seed. And when you're really not the number one seed, you're just a playoff team. And so with that being said, he went down because everybody really came and see Shay Shay, the Denver Bronco fan. You know what I'm saying? That's who everybody really was coming to see. It wasn't so much of him. You know, Broncos, baby. Broncos all day.
That's
you know, so.
Awesome.
Yeah, but when football season starts, you're going to see Denver products. But anyway, sometimes you can just get on your high horse and you think you more than what it is or what the program is, and life will bring you down to where you're supposed to be at. And I think that's what happened. When he ran away, all this, the people that he done worked with. So that's my opinion on it.
They said the people that the quitters of the year is Skip Bayless, Joe Biden, and J. Cole. They on Twitter calling.
No, put J. Cole on. J. Cole on the smartest.
Man, they got pictures. They got pictures on Twitter right now of Joe Biden and J. Cole jersey. Man, they wilding. Man, don't start the fight. Then quit, man.
I ain't no J. Cole jersey.
I hate to see him go. I really do. I know sometimes we say Skip Bayless. I like people like that because they are master trollers, and sometimes they fall for it. When I think about Shannon Sharp and Max Kellerman, I think they brought a lot to the programs because they both kind of fell victim into the same category. But I'm going to say this. I'm a grown man, and I've already have millions. I don't have to live in California. I can move back to Montgomery where it's cheaper. There's no way that Stephen A. Smith or Skip Bayless would ever talk to me like they ain't got away with it. Because guess what? They had to eat them damn words because I would not be muted. And at the end of the day, Skip gave his take on what he thought about Shannon Sharp compared to Tom Brady. And I would have said, hey, let's compare your ass to Stephen A. Smith. That's why he makes more money than you. That's all you got to do. But instead, him and when Stephen A. would tell Max Kellerman, this is why I don't like you. I'd have said the feeling is mutual. That's the problem. So it wasn't what Stephen A. Smith did or Skip Bayless. They took that verbal abuse. And to me, that was their fault. Now, I didn't think that Shay Shay was that popular either. So maybe he got on that high horse and thought he was bigger than the show. Where he made his mistake is You got rid of your main co-star and you bought in people that got fired from ESPN thinking they couldn't save ESPN. So how'd they go save Fox? It's not like they left and it was at the top. So you should have found a once you made that comment, maybe he didn't get the black code. Maybe when Lil Wayne was at his house, he didn't tell him Shay Shay about to leave. You know, it's kind of like when we see a shootout about to start, we get out early. We don't sit there and investigate. So
unlike no other vote, but go ahead.
Yeah, he should have found somebody who was
at the top. After Ryan something. Clark, Dominique Foxworthy.
You go bring people that got fired. How you go get somebody that got fired from what network because they was in generating ratings and you bring them to yours? That was his mistake. Shannon Sharp trying to fight the whole OKC and everybody basketball team, but he got this 70-year-old man. I'd have told him, shut up and dribble. That's what I would have told Skip Bayless.
So, y'all think Skip just going to stick to podcasting or?
Well, his podcast not even doing that well, according to the news. You know, and if you look at, you know, when Shannon Sharp left, the show went to Kaka, you know, and as soon as it went to shit. Oh. And when he got over on First Take, and he's only on First Take Tuesday and Wednesday, and those are the two highest rated days of First Take. So Shannon Sharp brings a big fan base with him. So y'all need to give Unc his
give him his props.
Yeah, give him his props.
Like fantasy football, it hadn't been the same without Eazy-E. We need to give him his props.
Who brought Shannon Sharp to the forefront? Who brought Stephen A. Smith to the forefront?
Skip Bayless.
So who, if me, I have bringing Unpredictable to the forefront and bringing Trigger Man Joe to the forefront. And they end up
bigger than you.
Yeah. So
that ain't hard to do though, you know what I'm saying?
Hey yo, who told you that?
Oh, I was on mute. I thought I was on mute.
Diddy.
Nico say anything at any time. You gotta brace yourself.
Well, all right, the thoughts out the old Skip and I wouldn't mind seeing skipping Stephen A. again.
I can't stand Stephen A. I love when somebody said Max Kellerman is more black than you. That really put the dagger. I got to get rid of Max.
Tell Skip we got a spot on for him on this show.
Yeah, Skip, come on.
You got to tell LeBron James jersey though.
That was Shannon Sharp's fault. He know that Skip Bayless loves Tom Brady. You can't talk about his idol.
Yeah, he love him.
Yeah, but
I like about Skip Bayless. He a Cowboy fan.
You see what happened when you start talking down on LeBron James all the time? You see how that boat floats?
It only took 22 years.
Well, some of us got to enjoy the WNBA All-Star game last night. Together. Oops for me too. I got
who won?
Whoa! Yeah, I was at home. I was.
They didn't declare one.
I was being a father. I was being a father, but I was watching it.
Let me break that. You was being a father, so there's a time when you're not a father. Is that what you?
I was in super father mode. Well, did not.
Oh, now you want to clean it up?
I did not have a father. Yeah, I could not leave home and go watch with the fellas, but
I could have wrote you.
It was a good game to me.
Very, very good game. Back to the game and not
who won?
Who you think won?
NBA, like I said.
The Olympians didn't win.
No,
hell no.
Got blowed out.
Blew out.
Yeah.
That what's her name? Awumba. Hey, what's her name?
Erica. Arika.
Yeah. Yeah, she had 25 points in the third quarter, I think.
No, yeah. She went for what, 30? 34. She went for
like, 34.
She went for 34 all overs in the second half. Shout out to Cheryl Miller, coaching that and having
Cheryl
that
Miller goal. Coach.
Yeah, she coached the
she
team.
She coached WNBA.
You know, she was a baller back in the day now. UNC.
Yeah, one of the greatest.
Pamela and Paula McGee. Bayou Barbie had a double-double.
right? And CC, what y'all call a CC? Oh, LSU. No. Y'all call a CC
downtown?
No. Hey, they ain't let me DJ in there. They're like, they're gonna let me come. So we not talking about them on this show till we DJ.
Till we get a
paper. But I DJed that once before. But shout out to them. CC Kayla Clark almost had the assist record, but around the 3 minute mark, 3-4 minute mark, it took a long time to get back in the game. The play didn't stop because USA was trying not to get trashed out. Mm-hmm. And by the time she got back in the game, the assist point was over. I'm gonna go back and look and make sure that Caitlin Clark didn't get in and try to throw some assists and people passed the ball instead of shot it to keep her.
A 180 on my stance on Caitlin Clark. She's been steady cooking. I'm not saying I got anything to do with it, but I seen where this thing was going. That girl, man, she's lethal.
Yeah.
And Stella got her groove back. She done found her groove from Iowa, straight cooking. What they did right now?
Man, that how it look in Boston, just like that.
Goon squad, leprechaun.
I thought that was Ellis Minions. But you know what, Joe?
She's finna take over the league, huh?
But I think with Caitlin Clark and Angel Reese, and I know it's another rookie. I forgot her name. But they came in with sizzle. They're not the best players. We know that. They may be on the outside of the top 15. But I think when I watch a lot of shows and I hear the ladies talking about the product that's been there, it has. And has these networks promoted them? Yeah. Thanks. But when you got people coming in, we never said give them an easy pass. We just said, hey, embrace them and now you're getting what you've been looking for, exposure. Yeah, and instead of making them the enemy, instead of making them an ally and taking advantage of it, they're making them the enemy for some reason. Me?
Yeah.
Well, they don't level ground right now with their performance the last night. They don't level ground.
Yeah.
So it's not an uphill battle no more for them, because they both of them proved that they could and could have played well on the Olympic team.
Yeah, but the choice that they made, now they regret them because they could have benefited greatly from it. You know, they dropped the ball. It just don't make no sense to even go that route, because you could have gave them the spotlight and still been hard on them, rough them up, but benefit from what they have to offer, you know?
Yeah.
We know hazing is a part of it, but sometimes you got to embrace it. And we know there's a history bigger than those two, and the pillars of the league prior to, and those who didn't get a chance to play in the league because it wasn't there. But man, they bringing. We went out to eat to go watch the NBA All-Star. I didn't even break for lunch to go watch it before then. So it's bringing interest to people, and now we're seeing the talent, but it has nothing to do with the marketing of the WNBA. It has to do with these individuals marketing themselves and having their own brand and making it popular.
Hold on, five years ago
up until now, we would have never even considered.
Breaking news.
Hold on, let me do it. You do it.
LSU sophomore cornerback Jajavian Torino.
Yeah, let me do it. Somebody can read. Go ahead.
That's old news. That was
surrenders to authorities on charges of video voyeurism.
The difference is you wear your watch.
Hold on. You made me mess the wrong button.
My time is.
Oh.
Sick Negro.
I'm bringing back.
This is a sick Negro.
Voyeurism. Video voyeurism.
Who that? Yeah. That's
a legend. Nothing proven.
All them freaks over there at LSU.
Hey, on behalf of LSU, we apologize. They couldn't do it like Bama and keep it in the family, make it their cousin.
Well, on behalf of LSU,
I watched.
He's a freaky ass nigga.
I watched that Clippers show. It was real good.
Yeah, good job.
Exceeded my expectation.
Yeah, I told you it was gonna be a good show for us. Why we'll discuss it.
Well, Lawrence Fishburne, man.
Hey, man, LSU can't be positive, can't be great at everything. We taking over the WNBA. We taking over track and field. We taking over the funds in Mobile. I mean, we gotta follow at some point.
OBJ said, watch out, he in Miami now, so it's finna get real.
Lord, he like people boo-boo on his face. That's a whole different odd. I don't know about that guy.
Well, shout out to the WNBA. And like it was said, the talent been there, because you got an individual that did this 4 years ago, won the MVP. And I like her sister. Her sister.
Sue Bird?
No.
Aruka
I thought you said my boy about him reading. You can't even pronounce the name.
Aruka.
I ain't reading it, fool.
That don't matter.
Hey, what happened to speaking of WNBA?
You look like an African. You should be able to help us.
You should be a racist. You are a racist.
Speaking of WNBA, what happened
I'm
to Monica
you
McNutt?
To Donald Trump.
I ain't been seeing them on First Take since she tried to call out Stephen A. Smith.
Ooh, that's a good point. I love what she did, though. Oh, I love it.
I didn't. Nobody cared. That's why they didn't watch it.
Put him on mute.
You know why? You couldn't argue with a woman on TV, but you heard Shay Sharp? He didn't care.
Yeah.
Shay Sharp was going for a head.
That look on Stephen A. Smith's face was priceless.
Speaking of on the WNBA and the USA Olympic team, the men's team was struggling yesterday, boy. They
you know what the line on that game was?
40.
40 plus.
Ooh.
Yeah. I wonder what the money line was like.
Ooh. I don't know. But that's all I know was people say that Jordan and all these players played against plumbers and workmen. That was actually plumbers and workmen. with all due respect to the nation, because they did play well, I never even heard of that country before.
Islam? The nation Islam? What you mean, the nation?
It's called South something.
Sudan.
South Sudan.
Yeah, I didn't know they had a South Sudan.
That's where the helicopter fell down that over there some years ago.
I thought it was at South Central, L.A.
Boombaye.
Well, speaking of summer basketball, let's end the show. Doing a little NBA Summer League recap. Any comments on
the videos today?
Yeah, I didn't at church. Right. In the episode, and went kind of quick without the videos, and these blank topics that we spruced up that ESPN chose didn't really need any videos. I didn't need to see Skip getting fired, but NBA Summer League. And unpredictable. Go ahead, Kyle.
I was going to say that the young man that the Lakers drafted at the number 17 pick,
right?
He looks like he's ready to step in and play a role. You know, he may not ever be a star, but I would say that he looks mature. His body's more fit because a lot of time we develop at an older age, so he looks like he's ready to go through the league. He don't have to go through a lot of different changes. A 4th-5th year senior, he's seen it all. He's come through the struggles. He's overcame them. So I really like that young man. At first, when they was putting the Lakers as one of those teams that did well in the draft, I was kind of like, at 17, I mean, you're propping somebody up. But he looked like a man amongst boys, a legitimate, not an all-star, but a starter in summer league.
He ain't lying.
So I like the way he played. And I'm going to leave it at that because I think we said enough about somebody, Bronny James. You should be irrelevant. You got you had two good games out of six, and we supposed to throw a ticket to a party. Bronny James should be right now trying to be coming off the bench for UConn.
The guy you speak of, though, he has a little age on him. That's why he fell in the draft. It said if he wasn't as old, he would have been like a top 8 pick. So he should fit right on in with the Lakers seamless. Because they need somebody who can help them right now. And like you said, he's fully developed and ready to activate his powers on the greatest organization in basketball history.
I like the way he attacked the goal every time.
I thought the Celtics was the greatest basketball.
You done went crazy.
Who?
You know what it is.
Leprechaun. Yeah. He need luck on his side. Cheating.
You know what it is.
Yeah. And we already know, for some reason, like father, like son, you play 2 games, you got to sit out. So I guess the family tradition. Bronny James, I feel bad for him as a young man because he seemed like he's a good kid. But I just don't understand the social media defense for him. If he's the number 55th pick and I say he's not that good, why are we comparing him to Jaylen Brown and all of these great players that have done things in the league when he's 6'1"? Maybe say Patrick Beverly. I could live with Patrick Beverly. I could live with somebody who's a little pest that played point guard that's going to go in there and give you 15 minutes, you know, and D up the best player, not care, take charges. But for some reason, we putting this man as the best of the best. If he's number 55 and he's not relevant, why do we get so upset when we talk about him? He shouldn't be talked about. I don't even know who was the – I can't tell you another number 55 pick ever in the draft. So why do we care?
And we see who talks about him every week on this show.
I get tired of seeing – every time I watch sports.
Hey, what's Tony game. Parker, second-round pick?
We didn't talk about Tony Parker until we saw him in the finals getting double doubles. That's when we talk about Bronny. Until then,
and Ginobili was second round too. I don't know what pick they was though. But.
I noticed you spoke on father like son. Shout out to Scottie Pippen Jr. Dominating Orlando with a 25-point performance. 16
yeah, the Lakers
points.
Had him too.
16 points in the fourth quarter.
That man just shits me.
Then he followed
just another grown man
with 17 points, 6 rebounds, 11 assists, and 3 steals. The Lakers may have let one get away in Scottie Pippen Jr.
No doubt, no question.
But so they got rid of Scottie Pippen Jr. for Bronny James Jr. That's why the Lakers can't win now.
Well, we know them Jordan boys. They never mind.
What about them Jordan boys?
Speaking,
Jordan could have got his son to the league if he wanted to.
We forget he was the owner. He didn't have to ask permission. He could have just did it.
Yep. So this son, Jeffrey Jordan, whatever his name is.
I don't know. That's probably his middle name, Jeffrey.
Hey,
yeah. But, played at,
what about this?
UCF. He was decent.
He was all conference. Bronny James was all through General Hospital. and a note on Scottie Pippen Jr. We know it's summer league, but we only go by what we see right now. Because people talking about this Jaylen Brown meme. I remember people said he was going to be a bust also. I just never heard nobody come to his defense except his mama. But Scottie Pippen averaged in 5 games 20 points, shooting 50% from the field, 41% from 3, 88% from the free throw line, 5 rebounds, 8 assists, 3 steals per game. That's telling me somebody who not you may not ever be a role player in the NBA, but that tells me you should be on an NBA team.
Now, when he would have been a role player. You know, the Memphis Grizzlies had a lot of injuries last year, and he played probably the last 25 games of the season, was starting and put up some great stats.
Yeah, now if
but I used to put him on my fantasy DFS teams.
Now, if LeBron James Jr. would have put these stats up, I'd have been like, man. I'd have did like you with Caitlin Clark. I'd have did a 180. But you know what I did with Bronny James? I did a 360. I started saying he was hot garbage. I walked all the way around to the beginning, and I still see hotter garbage.
Dang.
Well, I mean, Scottie Pippen Jr. been in the league about 3 years, man. Get
22. Undrafted.
Appreciate that, PSPN. But no.
That's the same thing, Bronny. Undrafted. That's what it should have been.
Right.
Anybody know how much Patrick Beverly made to go overseas?
$4 million.
That's it.
Yep, $700,000 increase. They offered him $3.2 million.
Wow. They
went over there for four.
It's some girls that go to Dubai for that. There's some girls that go to Dubai for a weekend for that amount. I mean, yes.
Do shit.
No, I don't know.
Shout out to Scottie Pippen's son.
Yeah, you said we ain't gonna shout out his mama. You already shouted out Bronny James' mama, but we ain't not gonna.
Well, we already know about his mama because going to take care of that.
Now, Scottie Pippen Jr. mama probably could have had him playing quarterback, star quarterback.
Jordan's son still doing that with his mama?
No, I think he moved on like Jaylen Brown moved on. Shout out to Jaylen Brown. He making comments to his new girlfriend about Brandon James, but he looked like a G when he walked in there.
For real?
What was the summer league game? Mm-hmm. To see Brandon.
That was a waste of money.
And he walked out with his new girlfriend. She played for the Sky, and he walked out with and his girlfriend holding Angel Reese's hands. I don't know if y'all seen the footage, but
Megan Good hug Michael Ealy like that. Now her boyfriend they ain't do nothing.
Y'all missed the first part of the clip. He hugged, dapped up and shouted out an old boy before he did anybody.
They just
cut that out.
This is a sick Negro.
Yeah.
That how you do
it. I saw that too.
No, that how you do. Wow. You get them out of the way first.
He looked a little salty though. He didn't look too kind.
The man already was on papers. He already been in trouble. He can't do nothing now.
Yeah, he can't do that.
Michael Vick?
No, Elo, whatever name is.
It's good to see a black woman saving lives. That white women. Hey,
I'm disappointed in Jaylen Brown though.
They not like us.
Man, first of all, I'm disappointed him going watch Bronny James to play and looking for something. Going watch Bronny James playing looking for something good. It's like me thinking I'm going on a blind date with an Instagram girl and come to find out she a Weight Watchers girl. I'm gonna be highly disappointed.
Well, shout out to Jaylen Brown and shout out to Bernice.
He made the Olympic team.
Bernice Burgo. He decided to go younger and went with the athlete. So shout out to him. Yeah, he walk around with them two women. He'd be all right this summer.
Shout out to the father to stay home with the daughters and not go to the WNBA meet and greet Buffalo Wild Wings. Shout out to the fathers.
Yeah, man.
That's what I'm talking about, man.
Yeah, shout out to the trophy husbands that go to the fine dining restaurants to be shown off by their wives.
Spending money I ain't got.
Chocolate.
God, yeah. I could use his money somewhere else.
I'm saying, when you
pay everybody a lunch dinner.
Joe, did you get permission from Francine?
The mother. I'm dead. Oh Lord, have mercy.
Yeah, man. Hey, shout out. Summer League was pretty good. I seen some people, and even though they post about it, they don't give you a chance to. I think some of them the guys from France that came over, I think they need some major work. Because I'm never going to excuse that you're going old for whatever being that tall. So time to hit the gym and time to take it seriously because that did look bad. The only saving grace that they had was that Bronny James was in the summer league. Other than that, they would have been a punchline for years.
Well, Atlanta went 5-0 in the summer league. So shout out to them.
To Atlanta that they didn't cave in and take the kid Star, because everybody thought they was gonna take Star, and they took the kid from overseas. Shout out to Atlanta.
He didn't work out for Atlanta. He didn't want to be in Atlanta.
Hold up, man. You said Atlanta did what in the summer league?
Oh, I thought they said they went 5-0.
Man, you better reverse that shit.
Oh, my bad. My bad.
Get him, Chuck.
My bad. They went 0-5.
You didn't hear me?
That was 5.
Look, he can read, y'all.
Look, you ain't just hear me tell you a few minutes ago they had all that Atlanta stuff in there on sale at Walmart. Man, that's why.
He's not a good listener.
Hawks, Falcons, everything Atlanta on sale.
Well, that's all right. That's just like you said last week, we could get Cooper Flag. We could get another first round pick.
Yeah, this was I think this was a weak draft. Now, it may pan out better than we thought. Because I know, almost 20 years ago when they had the Chris Paul draft, that was considered weak. But they found some Hall of Famers, so maybe it'll pan out. I just know that number 55 won't be in the league a day after his dad retired.
I think it's gonna be a couple of the playoff teams that's in the mid, like the 6, 7, and 8 seed. The picks that they drafted, them the ones that are gonna pan out for them. Them the ones I think.
Yeah, no pressure. And then
Okay.
Did y'all talk about what Joel Embiid said about his team?
No.
He sucked.
Do you know we just started talking basketball? Go ahead. What did he say?
That they suck?
I can't remember the exact words, but he said, like, we got too many old players. Our team is not built to win the gold. We're not good enough. Something to that extent.
He must because he need to be on the bench. Right. He need to come off the bench.
Yeah, Google he went get exactly. I'm like, I can't believe this man is.
He should have went to Cameroon.
Look at that Chester Cheeto over there.
Lee,
like, he got easy money. Like, he got easy money.
You ain't won yet.
Man, this shit is old. Hey,
Joe. You know what, Joe?
South Sudan, that's all I'm going to say.
You ain't won yet.
You better get one of these jerseys.
Hey, man, I just seen a fish jump out of the water behind you, man.
For real?
Yeah.
Hey, thing, Joe, know what that remind me of? Even though I think MB was watching our show. Hey, MB, I got copyrights to that. I said that when they picked the team, that they were old, broken up. And that goes to show you the lack of talent the U.S. has. That's why when people say the players that they are better, if they're so much better, why are we sending the oldest people possible over there to win? Where's these young stars under 28?
What do you think the WNBA team, I mean the women's USA team gonna win gold?
As long as they don't play against the All-Stars.
Hey, with that, that's a wrap, man. Unpredictable, you got any final words for the show?
Final words. We go, you know, because I kept it serious today. I kept it politically correct. Final words, Jaylen Brown, Kyrie. Hey, I love your enthusiasm. You want to be activists. You want to give to the community. You want to educate. But before you do that, you have a responsibility to your family, and you make your money first. And then once you retire, that's when you start running your mouth. Until then, you keep it quiet, you shut up and dribble, and when you retire, you tell it all.
Right.
Uh-oh. My
daughter made me a bracelet. And
why you not wearing it?
I just had it on.
Oh, my bad. I thought that was candy on there. You was about to eat it.
No,
he walked to. He jumped.
No, we ran out. She kind of. She
kind of dropped it. Candy.
She kind of dropped it when she. So we ran out of red and blue when she dropped it. So she brought it back in, it got a lot of colors on it. So I got to be careful where I wear this at.
See that?
That's true.
Yeah, shout out.
About that yesterday.
That's true.
President, we were saying the money that you losing by running your mouth. You could be giving that to schools and helping the black community if you go just give it away. Just be quiet. The money that you lost, you could have gave it to the communities, the schools, and everybody would have prospered. Talk about them when you leave.
Right.
Wait
right.
Till the NBA, I'll see you in 3 years.
Right. Clutch, you got a quote?
Oh, everybody else don't want, nobody else want to say that? We good?
Clutch, you got a quote?
Yeah, I got a quote. All right, here we go. This is a simple one. It always seems impossible until it's done. Failure is a condiment and gives success its flavor.
Okay. Read it one more time for me.
They was having sex with a virgin.
What?
What'd you say?
Success is a condiment?
Oh, because I live by these quotes.
It always seems impossible until it's done. Mm-hmm. Failure is a condiment.
Oh,
that gives success its flavor.
Cool.
Indeed. Check. Go like and subscribe. If you subscribe to the pod, go like our Facebook page. Or you can tell these guys how wrong.